An annoyance you might be familiar with are vehicles who refuse to move without getting bogged or even immobilized when moving off-road. Why does this happen? There are multiple factors that impact this. The first factor is terrain type. In mud or woodland, you are more likely to bog than in dirt or grass. So much you most likely already knew. There are, however, other factors involved. A short notice.
The following statements are based on trials with groups of 25 vehicles with common traits and are repeated 15 times over a distance of 680 meters to compare how many made it across either the whole distance or how many made it over at least half the distance. This gives us data of 375 vehicles for any given trait or condition, so that we can at least assume an approximation of a representative result.
The notes for the trial data can be found in the community section of my channel. But be warned, the notes are handwritten and the idea to publicize them was not in my mind when I wrote them. Another factor is ground condition. Something that is often overlooked by new players, but has a significant impact. On dry dirt, of 375 vehicles driven by conscripts, 373 reached the other side of the field. Two vehicles got immobilized, but made it over at least half the distance. 32 vehicles got bogged in the process. Compared to wet dirt, where only 342 vehicles made it across the field, another 15 managed to cross at least half of it, while 18 got immobilized before even reaching the halfway point, and 240 vehicles got bogged in the process. So check the conditions tab before you order your less experienced vehicle crews around. This brings us to the next factor, crew experience. The more experienced your crew is, the less likely your vehicle bogs down. Going back to our wet dirt field, with elite crews, 372 vehicles made it across, one got immobilized after the halfway point, and only two got immobilized before reaching the halfway point. Just 59 vehicles got bogged in the process in this case. So think twice before reducing vehicle experience in bad weather or terrain. Another factor is, of course, off-road capability. It's rather self-explanatory. The higher the off-road rating, the more the chance of bogging on any given terrain is reduced. If we send vehicles with elite crew and off-road rating 5 over a wet mud field, 123 vehicles reach the other side, while 99 make it past the halfway point. If we do the same to a vehicle with off-road rating 2 and elite crew, 12 reach the other side and only 53 make it past the halfway point. In these conditions, nearly all vehicles get bogged at some point. I didn't bother counting how many, if any, didn't. But off-road rating alone is not telling the whole story. Because it also makes a difference if a vehicle is tracked or not. Tracked vehicles can perform better than wheeled vehicles. If we again use a wet mud field, only 17 wheeled vehicles with off-road rating 3 made it across, while 66 made it past the halfway mark. While a tracked off-road rating 3 vehicle in comparison managed to cross with 51 vehicles and an additional 72 past the halfway point. In both cases, the crew were of elite experience. But it's not always the case that tracked vehicles perform this much better than wheeled ones. It appears that in earlier World War II titles the differences can be way less pronounced. Comparing a wheeled vehicle with off-road rating 3 to a tracked off-road rating 3 vehicle, 17 wheeled ones made it across, with 82 more passing halfway, and tracked vehicles got 18 across, but only 59 more passed the halfway point. It is likely that other metrics play into the performance, most likely power. While in the first example of wheeled versus tracked, we had a power rating of 4 on the wheeled vehicle, the tracked counterpart had a power rating of 3, while in the World War II example, the wheeled vehicle had a power rating of 4 and the tracked vehicle only of 1. I would consider that a significant difference. A factor I am, however, relatively sure makes less of a difference is weight, given the same off-road performance and means of movement, meaning wheels or tracks. I tested half tracks significantly below and slightly above 8 tons, both with off-road rating 5. The result, the vehicles above 8 tons performed consistently worse on average than those below 8 tons. However, again we had also a disparity in power. The lighter vehicle has a power rating of 4, the heavier vehicle of 1. The reason why I'm relatively sure that weight makes less of a difference is the next test. Both vehicles are wheeled with identical characteristics in speed, power, turning and off-road capability, but one weighs 0.7 tons, the other 0.9 tons. So the only difference is the weight, making one vehicle nearly 30% heavier. Again, elite crew experience for both vehicles and the same wet mud field. Overall, 45.9% of heavy vehicles made it across and 46.1% of light ones. 0.2% difference cannot be considered significant in my opinion. What also likely impacts bogging chance on wheeled vehicles is the number of wheels given the same off-road rating, in this case a rating of 2. When looking at the percentage that got at least past the halfway point, 15.8% of the 4-wheelers made it and 17% of the 6-wheelers. That seems to be not much of a difference until you see twice as many 6-wheelers made it across the entire wet muddy field, 20 compared to 10 of the 4-wheelers. In 8 out of 15 runs, not one 4-wheeler managed to cross the entire field, while this was only the case in 3 out of 15 6-wheeler runs. This might have been more details than you expected. At least it was for me. What did not seem to have an impact was the order given. It also did not appear that night time had a negative impact on bogging, so I make the assumption that reduced visibility does not impact it at all. I did not test if declines or inclines in terrain affects the likelihood of bogging. Might be worth a future investigation. If you found this helpful, don't be shy and show it with a thumbs up. Constructive criticism is also appreciated via comments. Clicking on the linked guide will show you also the differences between on- and off-map artillery. May your day be blessed, and thanks for watching.